मुस्लिम होते हैं ना, मुस्लिम लोग बोलते सूर्य की मंदिर। हाँ ऑप्शन फॉर्म वर्ड में सुन रहे हैं
सुरेश सर, थोड़ा साइलेंट। Good morning everyone, welcome you all for NTA lecture. So the screen is visible now properly?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Okay, so we can solve one or two examples and then we can start the second unit. So maximum power transfer theorem, maximum power transfer theorem. So we are solving the examples. Question number 2 I will take. Already we have solved this example by Thevenin's theorem, so we can take that one. One problem we can take based on the type 1 and another example we can take the type 2. Okay, so determine the resistance. This question was asked in the university question paper. Determine resistance to receive maximum power, to receive maximum power from source. Okay, determine resistance to receive the maximum power from source and also calculate maximum power. So this example we can take based on the type 1. So this will be the circuit diagram. Carefully observe the circuit diagram. This is the 100 volt power supply. This resistor is 100 ohm. This is 200 ohm. This is 400 ohm. And this will be the 300 ohm. Okay. And there is a load, variable load resistor between these two points. This is RL. So this is the question here. And determine the resistance to receive maximum power. So we know that according to the maximum power transfer theorem, the maximum power will be delivered from source to the load when load resistance is equal to source resistance. Manje RL's value here, source resistance, RS kiwa RTH manuya. When it becomes equal, then it is possible to receive the maximum power from the source to the load. Also, we can calculate that power by using that formula. PL max is equal to VTH square divided by 4 into RTH. Okay. So by using those formula, we can solve, we can get the answer of maximum power. So in the step when we are solving the numerical example using maximum power transfer theorem, we have to take the help of Thevenin's theorem, because we have to convert any complicated circuit into Thevenin's equivalent circuit, and then we can easily find out the condition for maximum power transfer as well as we can find out the P max value. So first of all, which theorem they are asking to use, that we can write, that is a maximum power transfer theorem. That name we can write, maximum power transfer theorem. Okay, so according to that we are going to find out first of all VTH, because it is type 1, you can mention for reference, because only one independent source is there, no dependent. So type one, in that first we are converting the given complicated circuit into Thevenin's. So for that VTH, RTH, then third one is Thevenin's equivalent circuit. Then we are finding out RL value, and fifth one is the Pmax, PL max only. Okay, so these are the 5 points we are going to use it. Now, for converting this circuit into Thevenin's equivalent circuit, first step of Thevenin's theorem is what? Identify the two terminals. So two terminals we have to identify based on the load resistor. Mujhe ha ek point jala and ha ek point jala. So these 2 points we can consider as a terminal A and B, and remove that load resistor, make it open. So I will convert, as well as I will convert that complicated circuit into simple circuit, rectangular form madhe. So this is the 100 volt. So this will be the rectangular form we can consider. It has its conversion ahead. So this is the B point I will take, and this is the A point I will take. So between these 2 points, we have to find out the VTH and RTH. Okay, so that you can remember. So resistor value is 100. This is 200 as it is. This is 300, and this is 400. Okay, now we can start to find out first point VTH. So VTH is nothing but open circuit voltage between two terminals. Already this problem we have solved. Maybe the value of resistor may be different, but type of circuit is remains same. This problem we have solved in the type 1 Thevenin's theorem. So there is no need to discuss in detail. You can easily understand, because this problem we have already solved. Only we are using now here maximum power transfer theorem. So here the voltage between these 2 points is we are going to consider as a VTH. This is A point, this is B. But the voltage at available at this point we can consider as a VA. This the voltage at this point is VB with respect to this ground. So VTH is equal to potential difference between 2 points, VA minus VB. Okay. Now, VA you can find out. VA is nothing but voltage across 300 ohm, and VB is nothing but voltage across 400. But if you are observing, this 100 volt is exactly parallel to this branch, total branch. 100 and 300. 100 volt is exactly parallel to this branch also. So by using voltage division, you can find out the answer of VA as well as VB. So voltage available at this point is 100 volt. So this is 100 ohm. This is 300 ohm. So we are finding out this VA. So VA is nothing but voltage across 3 and total voltage 100. So by voltage division, you can easily find out the answer, because this is the series circuit. Okay, ha series circuit hai. By voltage division, you can find out. So if you are using voltage division, VA is equal to total voltage 100 into 300, mhanje jyache across kadayche to 300 divided by 300 plus 100, because 300 and 100 are looking in series for this series circuit. So if you are calculating, 300 divided by 400 means 3 by 4. So 100 is 3 by 4 means 75. So 75 volt will be the answer of VA. Similarly, you can find out for VB. For that purpose, you can use another branch, but voltage is same, that is 100 volt. But resistor will change now, here 200 ohm and here 400. So this will be the VB voltage. So by voltage division, VB you can find out by same method. By voltage division, VB is equal to total voltage 100 into 400 divided by 400 plus 200. If we are taking the calculation, VB you can get 66.66. You cross check karai, values are same or not. Then you can put to calculate the VTH. VTH is equal to VA minus VB. So 75 minus 66.66. So VTH you can get 8 point something, you can get 8.34 volt. 8.34 volt. Now understood how to find out VTH? I will give 30 seconds, you can read it, everyone. If any doubt will be there, you can ask. Already this problem we have solved. 100 volt हा एक्झॅक्टली या ब्रांचला पॅरल आहे, टोटल ब्रांच या ब्रांचला पण पॅरल आहे. इन पॅरल सर्किट वोल्टेज ऑलवेज रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टंट ऑर सेम. एनी क्वेश्चन? यस सर नो? ओके. सो सेकंड पॉइंट इज आरटीएच. Okay, now RTH we have to find out. So RTH is somewhat in another method we have to find out, because we have to convert the given circuit into simpler form. Okay, because in this case the RTH is somewhat difficult to find out, but I will tell the simple method. By using that method you can find out the RTH correctly. You can take 1 or 2 minutes extra, but you can solve it correctly. That is important. Okay, now RTH we are going to find out. So RTH means what? Equivalent resistance between A and B. That is important. Equivalent resistance between A and B. Equivalent resistance between A and B. Now if you are observing this point here, we can take this point as a C point, this point as a D point, because A and B already we have taken C point and D point. So according to that we can convert. While finding out equivalent resistance, the 100 volt should be shorted. Okay, 100 volt me short karto. Is short circuited. While finding out equivalent resistance, if any voltage source is there, we can short it. If any current source is there, we are making it open. So there is no current source, there is only voltage source, so we can make it short. Itparan sagalyana kalale. So this is the A point, this is the B point. I will write. So newly we can take this point mana kiwa he point mana, this is D point, this is C point. Barobar hai? सो सी एन डी ऍक्च्युली एकच आहेत, कारण हे दोन्ही शॉर्टेड आहेत. बघा, बोथ आर दी शॉर्टेड. सो सी एन डी आर ऑलमोस्ट सेम. सी पॉइंट सी अँड डी पॉइंट आर सेम, 0 volt. त्यांचे म्हणजे दोन्ही पोटेन्शियल किती आहेत? 0 volt. नाव दिस सर्किट वी कॅन कन्वर्ट इन टू सिम्पल वे अकॉर्डिंग टू अवर मॅटर, कारण या दोन्ही मधलं आपल्याला रेजिस्टन्स मेजर करायचं आहे. वी आर finding out the equivalent resistance between A and B by observing from this side, RTH. So we can convert this circuit into rectangular. This is already rectangular, but either we can observe from left hand side or from right hand side. According to that we can convert this circuit. So conversion, while converting you can see that I will use this method now. So this I will consider as the A point, this I will consider B point, and from this I am observing the RTH. Okay, so I will consider like this. Now C point and D point I will take somewhere here. So this I will extend. So this is A only, because same point we have extended, same line we have extended. This is B. Somewhere I will take C here, C and D in between. But between A and C, which resistor is there? A and C madhe kutla resistor hai? 100. Okay. So I will like this because C and B madhe pan 200 manje C point common jala. So this is 100. This is 200. A and C manje ha point tumcha C jala. A and C madhe 100 hai. Okay. त्याच्यानंतर सी आणि डी पॉइंट सेम आहे म्हणजे इथं मी खालीच लिहितो आणि ए आणि डी मध्ये किती आहे 300. सो आय हॅव टोल्ड दॅट सी अँड डी सेम मीन्स सी पॉइंट अँड डी पॉइंट आर सेम सो बिटवीन ए अँड सी 100 इज देअर बिटवीन ए अँड डी 300 इज देअर सो सिमिलरली बिटवीन बी अँड डी बिटवीन बी आणि डी आणि अजून एक कुठल्या बी आणि सी बी सी घेऊया आपण बिटवीन बी अँड सी किती आहे 200 आहे that we can take here between B and C and between B and D put like 400. So like this, if you are converting, you can easily find out the RTH. So if you are observing from left hand side, 100 and 300 are in parallel, 200 and 400 are in parallel and both are in series. So while finding out RTH, you can easily write RTH is equal to 100 parallel 300 plus 200 parallel 400. So anyone calculate 100 into 300 divided by 100 plus 300 plus here 200 into 400 divided by 200 plus 400. This is a calculation killer. So 75 इकडचा लेफ्ट हँड साइड 75 ओहम दिस कॅल्क्युलेशन विल कम 133.33 आर टी एच इज इक्वल टू 208.33 एम आय करेक्ट
येस सर
ओके सो 208.33 यू कॅन गेट So up to this point, RTH, how I calculated, how I converted this circuit into simple one, that is very important. This conversion is very important. Those who understand this this conversion, they can easily solve such type of questions. Such type of questions, they can easily understand. Okay? So if any questions related to this RTH, you can freely ask. Okay, now we can move towards the Thevenin's equivalent circuit now because we have calculated VTH and RTH. Now next, from third point, it is simple. Thevenin's equivalent circuit we have to draw, then RL we have to find out according to the maximum power, then Pmax we have to calculate. That is the simple way. Only challenging is that how to convert the given complicated circuit into Thevenin's. Once you get, you can easily get the remaining answer. So Thevenin's equivalent circuit, you can easily find out now. So this is VTH, this is RTH, this is A point, this is B point. So between A and B, you have to connect now variable load resistor RL. Now, you have to mention the value of VTH. I think it is 8.3 volt and RTH is 208.33 ohm. Okay. Now, the fourth point is to transfer maximum power from source to the load. Source to the load RL. Condition is that RL must be equal to RTH. So RL must be equal to 208.33 ohm. So this is a simple one. RTH means RS. Next fifth point, Pmax, PLmax. So that is we can easily find out by using formula. VTH square divided by 4 into RTH. VTH is 8.34 square divided by 4 into RTH value is 208.33. So calculate and tell. So I got 0.083 watt, 83 milliwatt. Both are acceptable. So read it, all these points. It is simple way. So this is the first example. First example already we have covered based on type 1. This is the second example based on the type 1. Now one example we can take based on the type 2. Okay, any questions? So we can start now with number one based on type two. Type two MPT theorem, MPTT curve, maximum power transfer theorem. Okay, only one question we can discuss. This question already asked in the university question paper. What will be the value of RL? What will be the value of RL to get maximum power delivered to load? Delivered to load. Find Pmax. Find Pmax. So this is 3 ampere. This is 4 ohm. This is plus minus 0.5 V1. This is 4 ohm. This is RL. And the voltage across RL is V1. So if voltage across this RL will change as a V1, then the voltage of this dependent source also gets changed. That is 0.5 into V1. So if you are observing this circuit, this is the type 2 because independent source is there, along with that dependent source is also there. So at least one independent, at least one dependent, that condition it is following means we can solve it by using type 2. Okay, but we are going to use maximum power transfer theorem. In that we can use the Thevenin's theorem type 2. So according to the Thevenin's theorem type 2, we have to follow the procedure, and then we have to follow the procedure of maximum power transfer theorem. So first of all, we can find out VTH. Second one, we cannot find out RTH directly. We have to find out ISC. Then third one is RTH. Then fourth one is Thevenin's equivalent circuit. And then we can use the maximum power transfer theorem steps. That is fifth one is RL, sixth one is PLmax. Are you getting my point? So these will be the four points we have to find out by using type 2 Thevenin's theorem. So first of all, the step one we can apply, that is the terminal names we have to identify, and we have to remove that load resistor RL and make it open. Okay, now this is A point, this is B point. But what is the voltage across this one now? What is this voltage? We can take as a V1 as it is. Okay, V1 is the voltage. Now it is 0.5 into V1 as it is, we can take. Okay, even though load resistor is removed, the voltage remains same. But while finding out VTH, so this is the first point we are going to calculate. VTH is what? Open circuit voltage between A and B. Open circuit voltage between A and B. Okay. So for that purpose, this is 3 ampere as it is. This is 4 ohm. This is plus minus. This is also 4 ohm. This is open. A and B. So very interesting it is now. You can try to understand. Ata open circuit voltage manje kay? VTH. So VTH I will write. Instead of V1 now I will take VTH. If this is becomes VTH, the voltage of this dependent voltage source becomes also 0.5 into VTH. Okay. Now V1 is there, that replaced by VTH. That you can try to understand. Here V1 is equal to VTH. That you can try to understand. Now how to find out the VTH? VTH is nothing but voltage at this point. And voltage at this point, if you know, but here dependent source is there, no passive component, so it is difficult. Even though itla jar voltage find out kela, then it is difficult to find out the voltage VTH. So what you can do, if you are observing this point, this part, this is the practical current source. So use source transformation and convert. Use source transformation and convert into voltage source. Okay, so I will convert that current source into voltage source. You can convert, I will write here, convert current source into voltage source. So 3 into 4, that becomes 12. So 12 volt is the value of voltage source. And resistor becomes in series, that resistor as it is 4 ohm, only it is here parallel, in this voltage source it will become series. Now remaining, this will be as it is minus plus 0.5 into VTH as it is. Now, VTH is nothing but voltage across 4 ohm. VTH means just voltage across 4 ohm. So 4 ohm as it is. इतना वोल्टेज में क्या करते हैं प्लस माइनस वीटीएच कंसीडर करते हैं ओके ओनली दिस मच वी कैन टेक कारण ह्याच्यात मध्ये ऑलरेडी वीटीएच आलेला आहे और यू कैन ट्राई टू एक्सटेंड डोंट वरी बट ओनली दिस सीरीज सर्किट इज देयर ओके ओनली दिस सीरीज सर्किट इज देयर इफ सीरीज सर्किट इज देयर द मीनिंग इज दैट ओनली वन करंट विल फ्लो ह्याच्यातून एकच करंट फ्लो होणार आहे दैट इज आय सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस करंट व्हाई आय टेकन आय इन अ क्लॉकवाइज बिकॉज plus is here according to VTH, plus is here and minus is here. Okay, so my hajar na giu naka, you can take with the help of this plus minus. So apply KVL in loop. So according to this current I, plus is here, minus is here, minus plus already there, plus minus is there, 12 is. So you can start from this point, minus to plus, that is the plus 12. Next plus to minus is there, that minus 4 into I. Next minus to plus is there, that's why plus 0.5 into VTH. And ha plus to minus ahe, tamul minus VTH is equal to 0. Ata ya equation madhe, in this equation two unknowns are there. One is VTH, another is I. So I means what? I means current passing through this 4 ohm also. So VTH divided by 4 kele ki, tamul I means the, but I is equal to VTH minus 0 divided by 4. That is I is equal to VTH by 4. Manje, voltage difference divided by resistance means that current. So put this in above equation. Therefore, 12 minus 4 into I is replaced by VTH by 4 plus 0.5 VTH as it is minus VTH as it is equal to 0. So this 4 and this 4 will get cancelled. okay. So minus VTH, minus VTH, that is minus 2 VTH. Tatla 0.5 minus kele ki kiti will baga. So it is 12 minus kiti onara tha? 1.5 VTH rana is equal to 0. So VTH is equal to 12 divided by 1.5. So whether it is 8 volt. Okay, so up to this point, everyone understood now how to get the VTH answer. Everyone read it. Everyone try to read it. VTH, we got 8 volt. Pahila kai kele? VTH, open circuit voltage. We can, it is difficult to find out node voltage. For that purpose, we have used their source transformation. So we have converted the current source into voltage source so that we can get only one loop. And based on that, by applying KVL, we got the equation. And in equation, I is there. So I we have replaced in terms of VTH. So we can get only one unknown, that is VTH. And that we got as a 8 volt. Okay. So this first point we have covered now. Now next point. Next point, we can find out the RTH. I'll keep VTH as a 8 volt as it is because it is required to determine the Thevenin's equivalent circuit. Now, second point is RTH. So while finding out RTH, we cannot find out directly here. So instead of RTH, we have to first find out the ISC. Hello. Short circuit current. Short circuit Hello. Current. Between A and B. Okay, short circuit. Circuit current between A and B. So this 3 ampere I will keep as it is. This is 4 ohm. Very interesting it is now. What are the changes will happen in the circuit due to the short circuit that you can observe and make it changes. The half what miss short killer. Okay. And this current I will give the name as ISC. Yes. Now tell me what is the value of V1 now? Karan as I cross the voltage V1 hota. Ata mi short kela V1 se value kiti asala pahe?
Zero.
Yes. So it is 0 volt. Barabar hai? V1 is 0 volt due to short circuit. Okay. V1 is 0 volt due to short circuit. If this V1 becomes short circuit, then what is the value of this 0.5 into V1? That also becomes 0 volt. Barabar hai?
Yes
or no? Okay, 0.5 into 0 means 0 volt. Now, this short path is exactly parallel with 4 ohm. Manje hejatla current kay asnar hai, 0 asnar hai. So due to which this 4 ohm will get open. Current voltage bhagi, heja across voltage pan ithe. Okay, so if it is 0 volt, just wait. Okay, so here the as terminals, as terminals, terminals A and B are shorted. This concept you can note down, and you can keep in mind. As terminals A and B are shorted, V1 becomes zero. Therefore, voltage value, voltage of dependent voltage source, voltage of dependent voltage source also becomes 0 volt. Also becomes 0 volt. Also 4 ohm resistor gets open. Gets open. Okay. Now, if voltage source is this dependent voltage source becomes 0 volt, means it is short circuited. Okay. म्हणजे 0 volt म्हणजे काय तर तुम्ही ब्रॅकेट मध्ये लिहू शकता शॉर्ट सर्किटेड. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दॅट वी कॅन मेक द चेंजेस नाव. स्टील द चेंजेस विल हॅपन. दिस इज 3 एम्पियर एज इट इज. दिस 4 ओम नाव आय विल टेक एज इट इज. नाव दिस वोल्टेज सोर्स बिकम शॉर्ट बिकॉज 0 volt इज देअर. दिस रजिस्टर 4 ओम इज गेट्स ओपन अँड दिस शॉर्ट सर्किट पाथ विल बी देअर. दिस इज ए पॉइंट, दिस इज बी पॉइंट, and short circuit path will be available. And this is ISC. Now still, this short circuit path is parallel to this 4 ohm. So again, this 4 ohm gets open. So again 4 ohm is parallel with short path. This is, I will take as a short path. Again, 4 ohm is parallel with short circuit. Therefore, 4 ohm resistor gets open now. So due to which what will happen? Only the 3 ampere will remain as it is, and this short path will remain as it is. So this is A point and this is B point. So anyone can tell what is ISC now? 3 ampere. Okay, so here the ISC will be 3 ampere. Therefore, ISC we can get as a 3 ampere. Okay, so ISC, once we get the 3 ampere, now RTH we can get here. RTH, that is third point. RTH is VTH divided by ISC. So VTH is 8 volt, ISC is 3. So RTH 8 by 3 You can keep 2.66. Or 2.66. You can take. In fraction also you can take the value. That is also okay. Okay. So now these 3 points we have completed. VTH, ISC and RTH. Now next 4th, 5th and 6th point. That will be the easy. That will be the very easy. Thevenin's equivalent circuit you have to draw. You have to connect the variable load resistor. You have to find out according to the condition RL must be equal to RTH. And in last step, we have to use the formula of PLX. So we can solve that one now. And we can complete this example as well as unit number one. And then unit number two, we can start. So here, the fourth point will be the Thevenin's equivalent circuit. So according to that, we have to draw the Thevenin's equivalent circuit plus minus VTH. This is RTH. This is the variable load resistor RL between A and B. Okay, now RTH and VTH value you can mention. VTH is 8 volt, RTH is 2.66 ohm. So fifth point is to transfer maximum power from source to the load. Goes to the load RL. What is the condition? RL must be equal to RH or RTH. So RL must be equal to 2.66 ohm. Okay. So fifth point over. Sixth point is PL max. So PL max formula you can use it. That is the VTH square divided by 4 into RTH. VTH is 8 square. Divided by 4 into 2.66. Calculate and tell. I think it is 6 point something it will come.
6.01.
Yes. So it is 6.01 watt. Okay. That is the PL max. 6.01 watt. So in this way, you have to find out. So last two steps are very easy. Three steps you can consider: Thevenin's equivalent circuit, then condition for maximum power, and then formula you have to use that to calculate the PL max. Only challenging is that how you are going to convert the given circuit into Thevenin's equivalent circuit, and that we can decide by using type 1 or type 2 classification. Okay. So if anyone having any questions regarding this example, you can ask. Otherwise, we can close this unit number one. We can complete it already. And we can immediately start the unit number two. Anyone having questions? Okay. Okay. The screen is visible?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we can start the unit number two today. We have completed the unit number one. So unit number two, the name of unit number two is resonance. A very important phenomenon, very important concept. We are going to understand the different aspect of the resonance, types of resonance, then voltages, currents in the resonance, the effect of change resistance, the frequency response, the bandwidth, the selectivity factor, quality factor, Okay, so voltage and current magnification, applications of resonance. So all these points we are going to discuss in this chapter, as well as some numerical examples are there. We are going to solve those numerical examples based on the type series resonance and parallel resonance. So this concept is mainly useful, or mainly we can use this concept in the communication system, especially in the radio broadcasting, television broadcasting for audio communication. So series resonance or parallel resonance circuit, both are the important one. Only due to the connection of the linear components, they have classified into series and parallel. So in series resonance, the linear components like resistor, inductor, capacitor are connected in series, whereas in parallel resonance circuit, the inductor, capacitor are connected in parallel. That is the only difference. But the concept behind this is the resonance only. And resonance, what do you mean by resonance? What is the definition? What is the applications? What is actually part we are going to discuss? So in detail, we can start now to discuss these points. So first of all, we can discuss the resonance syllabus. So there are the two parts in this chapter two, that is series resonance, and second one is parallel resonance. So in series resonance, the series resonance concept, we are going to understand what is actually the series resonance, what is the nature of circuit, and what are the different components we are going to use it. Then impedance and phase angle of the series resonance circuit. So in series resonance part, we are going to derive the expression of resonant frequency, because resonant frequency plays very important role in the resonance. So how to derive the expression for that? Resonant frequency kutla factor thi depend asto. So that derivation, small derivation is there that we can try to derive it. Next, impedance and phase angle. Because we are going to, most of the times we are going to use AC source. So impact of impedance as well as phase angle on the other part of the series resonance parameters, that we are going to try to understand. Next, voltages and different voltages and current in the series resonance circuit, that derivation and that concept we are going to understand. Next, effect of resistance on the frequency response, because mostly it is related to communication. So if it is communication, then obviously frequency, bandwidth, amplitude, phase angle, so channels, so all these concepts will automatically come. So for that purpose, we have to understand the bandwidth, selectivity, okay, so here we are going to discuss all these points in the series resonance circuit. And after that, we are going to discuss now the parallel resonance circuit. In the parallel resonance circuit is also called as tank circuit. So in that same concept, we have to understand what is the tank circuit, how it will works, then on which principle, based on which principle it works. Then we have to derive the equation of resonant frequency. Then here also we have to understand the impedance and phase angle, then variation of impedance with respect to frequency, different voltages, different currents we are going to discuss here. Then numerical examples based on the series resonance as well as parallel resonance we are going to solve at the last. So this will be the syllabus and the contents in this unit number 2, that is the resonance. Our next point. So from this, only one possible of practical is that is the frequency resonance of series, frequency response of series resonance circuit. Okay. So already I have given the list. After that, if we are getting the time, then definitely we can do this experiment, that is a frequency response of series resonance circuit. So only one experiment is included from this chapter number 2. So same book you have to use, that is the circuit and analysis. First book, first textbook you can use. Circuit and network analysis and synthesis by A. Sudhakar and Shyam Mohan S. Palli, Tata McGraw-Hill publication. So this book you can use it for this unit number 2 for the reference. Okay, so next point, one more thing that is remaining, that is the CO. Okay, so for this chapter, there will be the second CO, that is the course outcome, we can say, that is ET213, that is the subject code. Second CO means ET213.2, right? Like we can write. And what is the CO? That analyze series and parallel resonance circuit. Very simple. Analyze series and parallel resonance circuit. Okay. So all CO you have to remember. There are the total 6 COs for this NTA subject. So for each chapter, there is one CO. There are the 6 chapters and 6 COs are there. Okay. So second CO will be analyze series and parallel resonance circuit. So we can move towards the meaning of title. Okay, so according to PPP, now we can move towards the title of the unit. So unit number 2, I will write unit number 2, that is the resonance. Is a resonance. So we have to understand what is the meaning of this title. Title of chapter. So what is the title of the chapter is resonance. So we need to understand what is exactly this concept. Okay, so here we need to understand the resonance concept. So what do you mean by resonance? So resonance, it is it is an electrical phenomenon. Why it is I am calling electrical? Because whenever we are considering inductor and capacitor and resistor, they are actually electrical components. Okay, so it is used to transfer the signal, to save the electrical signal. That's why electrical component, even they also called as electronics component. So it is mix up of electrical as well as electronics. So it is an electrical phenomenon which selects a particular frequency signal, which selects a particular frequency while rejecting or eliminating other frequencies. Okay, so म्हणजे काय करतो तो, समजा आता 100 different frequency चे signal आले आहेत, मला फक्त select करायचे 75 hertz चा frequency. So for that purpose I am going to use the resonant concept. There are the different signals are available, okay, in the air, but I want to catch only 75 hertz signal. मग ते कसे साध्य करणार मी? How I can catch only that 75 hertz signal? So that is possible by using resonant concept. So anyone can tell best example from A division? Anyone? Best example of this concept? Anyone heard about this?
Radio receiver.
Yes. So radio receiver already everyone is using, in the village also, in the urban, in the rural part, everywhere radio receiver. Means example we can take FM radio. So FM radio, actually the range for this is nearby 88 megahertz to 109 megahertz. He tala bandwidth allocate kele. Mag tyachyamadhye different channels ahet. Each channel is having different frequency, different channels. Okay, like 91.1 megahertz, 92.7 megahertz, 105 megahertz. Okay, different channels. In the urban, number of channels are more. In the rural, number of channels are less. Okay, so each channel is having particular frequency. So this particular frequency means what? They are using the resonant concept. जेव्हा तुम्ही रेडिओ रिसिव्हर, म्हणजे रेडिओ रिसिव्हर इज अवेलेबल इन मोबाईल, इट इज अवेलेबल इन द रेडिओ, इट इज अवेलेबल इन द ऑटोमोबाईल कार वगैरे, ऑटोमोबाईल कार लाईक दिस. ओके, यू कॅन ऑल्सो रिसिव्ह इन द स्मार्ट एलईडी टीव्ही, एलईडी एलसीडी टीव्ही. So these are the receivers. These all are the receivers. Okay, already I have taken here, radio receiver. So the frequency of this device will match with transmitter. That concept is called as resonance. Okay, receiver is either mobile or radio or automobile, car, in that radio is there, or smart TV. So these all acts as a receiver. As a frequency, tumhala set karayche radio ekda on kelyanantar. If you are setting at 91.1 megahertz, then you can listen whatever the going on that channel clearly. Jar tumhala 92.7 megahertz varti set karayche, so you can set you can change the channel. Junior radio hote baka, old radio, tyachya madhe asa apala knob firvayche. Okay, so asa frequency asa, so ita 91.1 megahertz vagere ani ita asa knob asayche. So we are rotating this knob and it will move. One red button will be there, like I will use here. So this will going to change. As you are changing this, it will move towards, so this is suppose 89. So this is 92.7. म्हणजे तुमचा जर इथं वगैरे कुठं जर नॉब आला, सपोज द नॉब इज कमिंग ऍट दिस पॉइंट, then you cannot listen properly either channel 91.1 or 92.7. kutla pan tumhala properly aiku yenar, but if this exactly match with 91.1, If your knob is at this position, then you can listen 91.1 megahertz channel properly. Are you getting my point? So in the digital, in the mobile, already the channel names will be there like this. 91.1 megahertz, 92.7 megahertz, then 95.1. So every channel is, if you're selecting this one, it will directly connect. If you're selecting this one, this will connect to 90. So in digital mobile, in the digital car, smart TV, everywhere now this option is there. But in analog, such options will be there in the old radio. So this, in this concept, in this communication system, they are using the concept of resonance. So whether you understood now, what is the resonance? Selecting a particular frequency. Example, 91, 92. While reject all other remaining frequencies. Just surround la jay kai frequency signal asset, te to reject karto, eliminate karto. So that concept is nothing but resonance concept. Maktala, for that purpose, either you can use series resonance or parallel resonance circuit. Most of the times they are using the parallel resonance circuit because the voltage remains same in the parallel resonance circuit. So this concept also we can use in television broadcasting, television receiver. Television broadcasting kiwa receiver mhanuya. Okay. We can use in the PA system also. General PA system we are not using here because PA system in that a simple communication is there. It is not long distance communication. It is a short distance communication. But for long distance communication, the resonance concept is most of the times we are going to use here. So this is the title or meaning of resonance. So if any questions will be there, you can ask. Otherwise, we can move towards the next point. So next one will be the central idea. Central idea of the chapter. Central idea of the chapter. So central idea means what are the things we are going to discuss in this unit. So this chapter deals with resonance. We are going to understood already. We understood concept of resonance. Then classification of resonance. So that we are going to discuss. Classification of resonance. Then impedance and phase angle variation. Impedance and phase angle variation with frequency. Then we are going to understand effect of resistance on bandwidth quality factor, selectivity. And frequency response. These we are going to discuss, and we are going to analyze. Analyze means solving the problems. Different analyze series resonance, series and parallel resonance circuit. Series and parallel resonance circuit. Okay, series and parallel resonance circuit. So in this way, we are going to deal this chapter. Means, या chapter मध्ये आपल्याला नक्की काय करायचे, काय समजून घ्यायचे, काय आपल्याला शिकायचे. Are you getting my point? So next point will be the importance of this chapter. Already we have discussed because in the title only I have told the applications of resonance. Importance of this chapter. Why we are learning this chapter in this subject? Why we are learning this concept? what is the use of this concept in the engineering field? What is the use of this concept for common people? That we can, if you are understanding, then we can easily understand the concept. We can easily analyze the circuit according to the application point of view. So in the guest lecture also, the expert person asked to you people whether you learn the resonance concept. Okay, he also told in the guest lecture, previous guest lecture, that resonance concept is very important in the industry field. Okay, so after studying this chapter, after completion of this chapter, after completion of this chapter or this unit, we are able to, our students are able to, we are able to analyze the series and parallel resonance circuit. Analyze and series parallel resonance circuit for various industrial applications. Analyze series and parallel resonance circuit for various industrial applications. Industrial applications. So common people are also using the FM for listening the songs, listening the different activities, different programs. Okay. So for that purpose, the radio is important one. Nowadays, our Prime Minister, since 2014, he is making one program on last Saturday of every month. That is Mann Ki Baat. So that Mann Ki Baat is going to broadcast by using radio only. Akashwani varnas te prasarit hota. Barabar hai? So for that purpose, how it is important that you can try to understand. For that purpose, the example I will give, the communication system everywhere, long-term communication system, long-term communication, and for that system, in that system, we are going to use this radio, this resonance concept. So example, best example is radio receiver, I will take. Okay, so this will be the title, central idea and importance of the chapter. So book I already told, then I already discussed the CO and syllabus. So if anyone having any questions up to this point, okay. So next part will we can try to understand the concept of resonance. Already we have discussed now resonance. So definition, once again I will write. It is the electrical phenomenon. It is the phenomenon which selects particular frequency signal, we can add, while eliminating or rejecting all other frequencies, Okay, so example, communication system, radio receiver. So now next we can see the type of resonance. So types of resonance, in that there are the two types: series resonance, and second one is parallel resonance. Okay, so in series resonance, R, L and C, these are connected in series. So in parallel resonance, P, resistor, inductor, capacitors are connected in parallel. So based on the connection of these linear components, they have classified into two types: series resonance circuit and parallel resonance circuit. Okay, now we can start. This will be the introduction of resonance. We have completed. Now series resonance we can try to discuss here. काय अडचण असेल, क्वेश्चन असेल तर विचारू शकता. नाव वी कॅन स्टार्ट द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ सिरीज रेझोनन्स. द फर्स्ट पॉइंट सिरीज रेझोनन्स. ओके, नाव सिरीज रेझोनन्स वी कॅन डिस्कस. इट इज द फिनॉमिनन. It is a phenomenon which selects, same definition will come, which selects a particular frequency, which selects a particular frequency signal, particular frequency signal, while eliminate or rejecting or reject all other frequencies in using series RLC circuit. So this word is very important. So series resonance means what? It is a phenomenon which selects a particular frequency. That frequency we can give the name as FR, R for resonance frequency. As upon manto, particular frequency means resonance frequency signal, while eliminate or reject all other frequencies using series RLC circuit. Okay, now the diagram I will draw. This is resistor R, this is inductor L, and this is the capacitor C. And suppose this is the AC voltage source VS is applied. So AC voltage source, as soon as applied, the current I will start to flow. Okay, at the current tumcha flow zala, once we are connecting the supply voltage VS AC volt for this RLC circuit, the current will start to flow in this direction, suppose. Okay, so current will be the same throughout the circuit because series circuit is there. So this is the figure one, series resonance circuit. Series resonance circuit. So when the resonance will occur, that is important. When the resonance will occur. Okay, so resistors impedance kiti asto? Resistance only, that is R. What is the impedance of RL? What is the importance of this L and C? So XL is impedance of inductor. Okay, and XL is equal to omega L, where omega is 2 pi F into L. Where L is the inductance value, F is the frequency of this signal VS. VS means kai? Vm into sine of 2 pi Ft plus theta. Okay, theta apun ita 0 giva. F means frequency. Kiwa asa hi manto, Vm into sine of omega t. Okay, so omega is what? Angular frequency. F is the frequency. Okay. So this is XL value, where XC is what? Impedance of capacitor. XC is what? Impedance of capacitor. So XC is equal to what? 1 upon omega C. That is 1 upon 2 pi F into C. Okay, where F is the frequency of input signal, C is the capacitor value. Now why I'm telling this? Because when the resonance will occur, at what condition the resonance will occur, That is very important. Okay, so for that purpose, it depends on the current and voltage phase difference. So phase difference is theta. So theta is what? Phase difference or phase angle. Now, okay, so this concept we are going to understand now. Give the attention, everyone. So in a series circuit, or series resonance circuit, current I leads or lags behind the applied voltage VS. Applied voltage VS depends upon values of XL and XC. म्हणजे हा जो करंट I आहे ना आणि तो VS अप्लाइड व्होल्टेज या दोन्हीतला फेज डिफरन्स किती आहे, म्हणजे I चा फेज डिफरन्स VS पेक्षा जास्त आहे का VS पेक्षा कमी आहे का दोघांचे इक्वल आहे फेज डिफरन्स झिरो. सो इफ करंट I लीड्स द अप्लाइड व्होल्टेज VS मीन्स व्हॉट विल हॅपन. इफ करंट I लॅग्स बिहाइंड द अप्लाइड व्होल्टेज VS व्हॉट विल हॅपन. अँड इफ द करंट I बिकम्स इन फेज विथ अप्लाइड व्होल्टेज व्हॉट विल हॅपन. So that we are going to discuss. Okay, so I will draw the phasor diagram now. You can give the attention, everyone. So this is called as phasor diagram. Phasor means phase related. So this is suppose VS on x-axis, this is zero value, and this is the current I. So suppose the current I is somewhere here. Okay, so this is the phase difference theta. This is the phase difference. Okay, म्हणजे हा इथं झिरो डिग्री झाला, इथं काय असणार आहे, अँटी क्लॉकवाईज उभीया 90 degrees, हिअर इट इज 180 degrees, अँड हिअर इट इज 270 degrees, अँड अगेन इट इज 360. ओके, सो इथ करंट आय अँड बिटवीन अप्लाइड व्होल्टेज देअर इज द पॉझिटिव्ह थीटा विल बी देअर, देन दिस इज कॉल्ड एज व्हॉट, करंट आय लीड्स, म्हणजे व्हीएस पेक्षा जास्त येतो फेज डिफरन्सनी. सो करंट आय लीड्स अप्लाइड व्होल्टेज व्हीएस बाय फेज अँगल थीटा. ओके, सो दिस इज द कंडिशन. ना नेक्स्ट कंडिशन इज व्हॉट, नेक्स्ट कंडिशन इज हाऊ वी कॅन शो इट, द करंट आय लॅग्स बिहाइंड. So this is the first point we can consider. So second point, so this is the VS, this is the I. So this is 0 degrees, this is 90 degrees, this is 180 degrees, this is 270 degrees, this is the anti-clockwise. The clockwise gela tar, this is 0 degrees, this is -90, this is -180, this is -270, and again this is -360 anticlockwise. Okay, ata samja current I lags behind VS. Lags manje to VS peksha phase difference theta ni phase difference ni maga hai. So this is the current I, and if you are comparing with the applied voltage VS, the angle between that is theta, it is lags behind. So this is the condition for current I lags behind applied voltage by theta. Okay, ya doni condition madhe, if the this is happening due to XL greater than XC and XC greater than XL. Okay, so why it is happening, that I will tell now. Okay. So current I lead supply voltage, this is happening due to XC is greater than XL. And this current I lags behind, that will happen due to XL greater than XC. म्हणजे या दोन्ही केस मध्ये त्याची व्हॅल्यू इक्वल नाही आहे एक्सेल एन एक्सी. सो फॉर दिस इन दिस केस वी कॅन नॉट गेट द रेझोनंट कंडिशन. मग रेझोनंट कंडिशन कधी येणार? वेन इट विल हॅपन. सो दॅट विल हॅपन वेन, लास्ट पॉइंट विद इन टू मिनिट्स वी कॅन कव्हर. सो दिस इज द वोल्टेज व्ही एस, दिस इज द करंट आय. सो वेन द करंट आय बिकम्स इन फेज विथ दिस अप्लाइड वोल्टेज व्ही एस. So this is the condition, what? Current I is in phase with applied voltage Vs. Okay, that is what XL is equal to XC. So this will be the condition. When XL becomes equal to XC, then we can say that current I is in phase with applied voltage Vs. In phase means what? Theta becomes 0 degree, phase difference becomes 0 degree. Okay, then chatla page jump. So this is the condition for resonance. This is the condition for resonance. This condition you have to understand. So resonance occurs when current I becomes in phase with applied voltage Vs, and that is possible when XL becomes equal to XC. Okay, so XL means what? 2πfL. And XC manje kay 1/2πfc. So based on that L and C value only we can control the resonance frequency. So this is the concept of resonance when it will occurs. So next part we can discuss in the next lecture. So if anyone having any questions, you can ask. Otherwise, we can stop for today. Okay, then we can stop.